Now for a look at the legal aspect of the Apple versus FBI battle, joining me now is Howard Krent. He's dean at the Chicago Kent College of Law. Great to have you on the show. This is really an honor.
Good to be here.
Is this case going to the Supreme Court?
Who knows? It's too early to tell, but it certainly raises fascinating legal issues.
It really does. What does this actually open the door to if Apple allows the FBI and DOJ to crack open that phone?
Sure. I mean, there's at least three different aspects. One is, can the FBI, on a case-by-case basis, decide when to order a company to develop new source code or to change an algorithm to allow someone to crack the encryption? Almost unprecedented in terms of legal ways, even though they've done it in an informal basis before. So that's one issue. Another huge issue, of course, is should the government be doing this at all? Maybe this should be up to Congress to make a prospective determination of how to balance security and privacy. Very complicated issue because there are obviously very important security and privacy issues at stake.
Will Tim Cook go to jail?
I don't think Tim Cook will go to jail. But the third issue I might raise is what's going to happen with the relationship between Apple and China. Apple so much wanted to get into that Chinese market.
It's a big market.
It's a huge market. They're number two sellers now of the iPhone. And if they turn over information to the U.S. government, perhaps the Chinese government is next.
Always a legal drama. Thank you for coming on. Please come
My
back
pleasure.
Again.